What is up, everybody? Thank you guys for tuning in to this next video of the P51B/C Mustang by Revel. In my last video, I took you through the basic history behind the boxing of the model itself and how it came to be such a great model that it is today. Today, we're gonna go through the back history of the pilot that flew this particular airplane and also the backstory of the other P51 as well. So follow along and let's get right into it. This is an exceptionally extraordinary story, and it's so cool to be able to build one of these things based on such an influential character in World War II. P51 with a mouth on it was flown by no other than Tex Hill. In 1939, Tex Hill started as a TBD Devastator pilot, which was a torpedo bomber pilot. And he actually was a torpedo bomber pilot off of the USS Saratoga. A little bit about the Saratoga is that it originally was a battle cruiser and they transitioned it into an aircraft carrier. It was one of the very first battle cruisers that was transitioned into an aircraft carrier in the war. This battle cruiser, which later became an aircraft carrier, actually had 8 battle stars by the end of its career. He was also trained to be a pilot of the Vought SB-2U Vindicator, and that was a dive bomber. And he actually flew those off of the USS Ranger. A little interesting fact about the USS Ranger was that it was actually built to be a carrier. It wasn't transitioned in from a battle cruiser or anything else like that. Now, both cruisers that he was actually based on, as a torpedo bomber and a dive bomber, were actually 2 of the only 3 battle cruisers and aircraft carriers to survive the entirety of the war. So he was a big part of history and how these big machines brought us to victory in 1945. And this is where his story really begins. In 1941, he joined the first American volunteer group, the Flying Tigers, where he learned how to fly a P-40, a fighter plane. So this guy knows how to fly torpedo bombers, he knows how to fly dive bombers, and now he knows how to fly pursuit fighters. After he learned how to fly the P-40, he was part of the 2nd Pursuit Squadron, called the Panda Bears. Tex Hill became an ace in 3 days, killing his first 2 aerial victories the first day, 2 the second day, and 2 the third day. End of the American Volunteer Group, he had over 12 victories. One was a quarter victory, which him and 2 others shot down a Japanese aircraft. Tex Hill commanded the 23rd Fighter Group. As a major, he led the 75th Fighter Squadron. And in 1943, finally when this aircraft came into his possession, he downed 6 more enemy aircraft in this flying machine. This also explains why there is a shark mouth on this P-51. Because he was part of the Flying Tigers group, and he wanted just that awesome shark mouth on the front of his Mustang too. Now, in this P-51, some say that he may have been the first pilot to shoot down a Japanese fighter with a P-51 Mustang. Now it is a P-51B, so it's definitely first of its class, but also it's just super awesome to have this piece of history on my shelf. So you gotta get yourself one of these and build it, because this is a great guy that did amazing things for this country. Next we have the P-51C Lucky Leakey II. And this is an awesome aircraft. It is super sweet looking. There's only a couple photos out there of this actual airplane, and it unfortunately is belly landed. In 43, served in overseas duty for the 504th Fighter Squadron and 339th Fighter Group in the Europe Theater of Operations. The group pioneered P-47 strafing runs and dive bombing tactics. The group flew over 447 combat missions. The group had over 330 aerial victories and 414 ground aircraft victories. This group's nickname was actually the Slybird Group. Unfortunately, Leroy Pletz was not able to win any aerial victories in this aircraft. He actually tried switching his drop tanks to his regular fuel and something went wrong. He couldn't fly the airplane anymore. The engine cut and he had to belly land this beast into a field. So that's what ended up happening to this awesome aircraft, but the decal variation is super sweet and should not be paid less attention to. I appreciate doing these videos. I get to learn a lot. I hope you learn as well. Subscribe and hit the bell to see and get reminded of all my content that's coming out. Thank you guys again, and let's get straight back to building.